Prince Harry's decision to keep the birth dates of his children under wraps has raised some eyebrows. According to the video news from Kate Middleton and the Queen News Version 2 channel, there are speculations that the Duke and Duchess of Sussex, Harry and Meghan Markle, might be overly secretive about the birth of their children. This contrasts with historical royal traditions, where the birth of children in the royal family is usually a transparent process. The channel emphasizes that there is no questioning of the existence of Harry and Meghan's children, but rather concerns about the circumstances surrounding their birth. The fact is that if the children were born through other means, allegedly, then they are not eligible for royal privileges, the channel stated. It's noted that this kind of secrecy is not common among senior royals. The video cited examples such as the late Queen Elizabeth II and Princess Diana, where the royal household and even the British government were significantly involved in the birth process. This involvement usually dispelled doubts and brought clarity. On the other hand, Meghan's birth was labeled unusually secretive by the news outlet. There are claims of conflicting information regarding the birth, including discrepancies in timelines and nature of the births. One of the examples given was that Prince Harry was allegedly high on helium during Meghan's labor, which the news channel deemed as outright ridiculous. Historically, the birth of royal children was an elaborate affair, confirmed and verified by palace courtiers and witnesses. In contemporary times, this translates into involvement with the royal household and open communication with the government. The news channel suggests that this transparency is important, especially when considering the line of succession and the granting of royal privileges. One historical example cited by the news outlet to underscore the importance of transparency in royal births was the Japanese succession crisis in 2006, which occurred due to a lack of male heirs. It demonstrates how critical the birth of a male heir can be, and thus the importance of clear communication regarding royal births. As Prince Harry and Meghan Markle deviate from this long-standing tradition by keeping the birth dates and details of their children private, speculations continue to swirl around the reasons behind their decision. Building on the discussion of royal birth traditions, the Kate Middleton and the Queen News Version 2 channel draws a parallel between the official nature of royal births and Meghan Markle's approach, which is seen as a stark contrast. The channel emphasizes that in the past, royal births, even in other countries such as Japan, were confirmed and verified by the imperial household and the government. This is in direct contrast to the secrecy surrounding Meghan's pregnancies and births, which some find perplexing, especially considering that her children are high in the line of succession. The news outlet mentions that transparency around royal births is crucial to quell public speculation, and the very presence of such speculation is unusual in itself. One commenter on the news channel's platform was quoted as saying, "It sounds counterintuitive and cruel, but I really, really hope that the children are the product of surrogacy. I would be devastated on those children's behalf if the truth comes out that Meghan was pregnant with and gave birth to both of them." This reflects the public's deep involvement and concern regarding the matter. Furthermore, both Harry and Meghan have been criticized for letting people speculate about their children's births. The news outlet quoted the same commenter, saying that if the children are indeed Meghan's, and Harry wrote the most ridiculous, untrue stories of their birth, and both of them clapped back at everything other than how those children were born, it would be the evilest thing that the pair of them have done. Interestingly, Prince Harry has previously spoken about how he was deeply affected by rumors concerning his own birth. He mentioned in the book, Spare, how the false claims that he wasn't the king's son traumatized him. Yet, critics argue that by being secretive about his own children's births, he might be subjecting them to similar speculations and rumors. Meghan's reaction to rumors has also been under scrutiny. The news channel highlights how she responded with indignation to rumors about her purchasing a copper bath for Frogmore, but did not address the surrogacy rumors which they thought she might label as racist or misogynistic. This selective response has led some to believe that she is content with letting certain speculations continue. As the story unfolds, the question remains, why is there such secrecy surrounding the births of Harry and Meghan's children? And what impact might this have on the royal family and their public image? Transitioning to a more serious tone, the Kate Middleton and the Queen News Version 2 channel brings attention to the concerns surrounding Prince Harry and Meghan Markle's children. The channel discusses the possibility that the secrecy surrounding the births of the children might imply something more troubling. It suggests that if the children were indeed born of Meghan's body, and the couple is still allowing speculations to circulate, it could potentially mean that they are not putting their children's well-being first. One commentator on the news channel's platform shared their concerns, stating, "The bitter fact is that those children were both born of Meghan's body. If even only Archie was born of Meghan's body, then that can only mean that those children aren't loved or cared about by either Harry or Meghan at all." This commentator expressed a preference for believing that there must be some compelling reason behind the couple's silence, as they couldn't fathom the idea of the children being neglected for personal gains. The channel emphasizes that the conversation should shift from speculations about the nature of the children's births to considering the real-world implications of such speculations. The focus, according to the news outlet, should be on the well-being of the children. The commentator articulated this concern, saying, "It should be a conversation about what this speculation actually means in the real world and in the real world. This boils down to whether two completely innocent children are being abused and neglected or not. And I really do not want to believe that they're being abused and neglected." Another commentator brought up an additional point, indicating that since the couple is often seen in the media but rarely show or mention their children, some people may jump to even more far-fetched conclusions, such as the children not existing. This, the commentator explains, is a natural progression of the surrogacy story going unchallenged. They noted, "More than that, though, is the fact that it's so incredibly rare that they do mention their children. And when they do mention them, the stories about them are bizarre and unbelievable. As the secrecy and limited mention of their children by the Duke and Duchess of Sussex continue, it leads to a myriad of speculations and concerns. The paramount question that arises from these speculations is what impact this may have on the children involved, who are unwittingly at the center of this whirlwind." Continuing on the topic, the Kate Middleton and the Queen News Version 2 channel introduces the idea that misinformation and conspiracy theories might be perpetuated by individuals not well-versed in the nuances of UK laws and monarchy. The news outlet proposes that some of the speculations might be fueled by a lack of understanding of the relationship between the British government and the monarchy. One of the commentators suggested that there might be chaos bots and individuals who are intentionally or unintentionally causing confusion. This commentator also expressed frustration with individuals who block or ignore information that doesn't align with their conspiracy theories. They pointed out that some people believe the king has the power to strip titles, which is inaccurate. The commentator stated, "Whether true or not, surrogacy, no children theories help chaos bots, because it's one of the examples of the king being weak and refusing to remove titles and their places in the line of succession, when the fact is that only the British government can change the line of succession." The same commentator touched on the complex nature of these speculations and how it is unlikely that any deep investigation will reveal the truth unless someone with first-hand information or legal authority speaks out. They mentioned, "It's so complicated and no deep dive will ever find out anything. We will only find out the truth if it's the truth. If someone involved breaks the NDA and says anything, or a member of parliament uses parliamentary privilege to speak about it in the House of Commons." As the news article draws to an end, it emphasizes that the lack of response from the Duke and Duchess of Sussex to certain rumors while they have addressed others raises questions. The commentator opined, "The Sussexes refused to acknowledge this when they acknowledged everything from yacht girl rumors to copper baths to Kate made me cry, and so on. Shows that they're monsters." The news outlet closes by inviting readers to share their thoughts on the unusual circumstances surrounding the births of Archie and Lily. The article concludes without a final verdict, but invites continued conversation and reflection among the public. It encourages readers to share, subscribe, and stay tuned for further updates.